हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द नेक्स्ट सेशन इन दिस लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन जेनेटिक्स एंड मॉलिकुलर बायोलॉजी। आई एम डॉक्टर योगेश पावड़े अंडर द सेम कॉम्पिटेंसी दैट इज BIC 1.2। वी आर गोइंग टू कवर टुडे द इनहिबिटर्स ऑफ DNA रेप्लिकेशन। द स्पेसिफिक लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस सेशन आर एट द एंड ऑफ द सेशन द स्टूडेंट शैल बी एबल टू एन्यूमरेट वेरियस इनहिबिटर्स ऑफ DNA रेप्लिकेशन। So what are the various inhibitors of DNA replication? The enzymes which are required for DNA replication, like for DNA polymerase, the inhibitors of that enzymes will be actually the inhibitors of DNA replications. Here there are like amyloid, cytosine arabinoside, vernolepin, acetylcholine. These are the DNA polymerase inhibitors. Let us see what are they. Amyloid is anti-mitotic drug. It acts as a DNA intercalator. The inhibitor goes and sits in between the nucleotides of DNA template, and it interferes with the function of DNA polymerase, and that's why the DNA polymerase function cannot occur and the replication is hindered. We have discussed cytosine arabinoside under the lecture on various major synthetic analogs of nucleotides. So you can refer to that for the details on cytosine arabinoside. There we have discussed the mechanism of cytosine arabinoside. How does it affects the DNA polymerase activity? We have discussed in detail, so you can refer to that. Next is vernolepin. It's a platelet anti-aggregating drug. It irreversibly inhibits DNA polymerase. Next is acetylcholine, which has antiviral and anti-mitotic property. It is a reversible inhibitor of eukaryotic nuclear DNA replication. It actually blocks the cell cycle at early synthesis phase. We have seen the cell cycle and various phases, right? So at early synthesis phase, this acetylcholine acts and blocks the cell cycle. This acts as a specific inhibitor of DNA polymerase alpha and DNA polymerase delta in eukaryotic cells, and also in some viruses its action is seen. In molecular biology, it has a very important role as an apoptosis inducer in HeLa cells. Next inhibitor in this category is DNA topoisomerase inhibitor. Now this is the another enzyme which is required during the DNA replication process apart from DNA polymerase, right? So this is anthracycline. So under this group there are four drugs. So those are doxorubicin, donorubicin, epirubicin and edarubicin. So these drugs are given as an anti-cancer drugs in most of the regimens of cancer treatments. So we can remember like doxo, dono, ep and ida. So rubicin is the common, and this is the suffix given for anthracyclines. Its mechanism of action is basically the DNA intercalation. Here the inhibitor intercalates between the adjacent base pairs of DNA. It inhibits DNA and RNA synthesis in highly replicating cells. So mostly the highly replicating cells are affected, and the cancer cells are the highly replicating cells. Without any restriction, they undergo multiplication, and those highly replicating cells are the actual targets of DNA topoisomerase inhibitors. They subsequently block the transcription and replication process also. Topoisomerase 2 poison, here it intercalates into DNA and form a stable anthracycline DNA topoisomerase 2 ternary complex, thus poisoning the enzyme. So it actually poisons that topoisomerase 2 enzyme by forming a stable, it is a stable anthracycline DNA topoisomerase 2 ternary complex. It impedes the ligation of double-stranded DNA breaks, thereby arrest growth and lead to repair failure. So repair failure and the programmed cell death will be initiated, right? So this is the mechanism of action of DNA topoisomerase inhibitors, especially anthracyclines. Now coming to the next variety of DNA topoisomerase inhibitor, that is fluoroquinolones. Here it has a slightly different mechanism of action. It inhibits the bacterial DNA gyrase. So the DNA gyrase, which consists of 2A and 2B units, there are 4 subunits. Okay, so the A subunit carries out nicking of the DNA, a breaking of DNA, and B subunit introduces negative supercoils, and then A subunit reseals the strands. So both nicking and resealing is done by the A subunit, and B subunit is involved in introducing negative supercoils. Basically, fluoroquinolones has a very high affinity for A subunit and not the B subunit. So it interferes with its strand cutting and resealing function. Because the subunit A has a function of nicking, and then after the negative supercoils are introduced by B subunit, resealing function is shown by subunit A. So these functions are affected. In gram-positive bacteria, the major target is topoisomerase 4. Gram-positive bacteria has topoisomerase 4, which is the major target of fluoroquinolones. The mammalian cells possess an enzyme topoisomerase 2, which has very low affinity for fluoroquinolones. Hence, the low toxicity to host cells. So, we can say that fluoroquinolones has the least toxicity in human beings when it is given as a treatment to cover up gram-positive bacteria which has topoisomerase 4. Because fluoroquinolones are specific for topoisomerase 4, our mammalian enzyme topoisomerase 2 has very low affinity, and that's why least toxicity seen in mammals. Then what are the other DNA replication inhibitors? Mostly those are alkylating antineoplastic agents, alkylosulfonates, mitomycins, nitrogen mustards, nitrosourias, oxazaphospinones, phosphorodiamidates, platinum based antineoplastic agents are there. Let us see what is the mechanism of action. Alkylation of DNA is used in chemotherapy to damage the DNA of cancer cells. Like busulfan is alkylosulfonate. Mitomycin actually is anti-tumor antibiotic also. So this antibiotic is used as anti-tumor agent, and it is a DNA replication inhibitor. Nitrogen mustard are the agents which forms the inter-strand crosslinks. ICLs are the inter-strand crosslinks which are introduced by nitrogen mustards, and because of which DNA replication cannot occur. Both the strands will have inappropriate linkages between the nucleotides, and it will affect the DNA replication process. Then there are nitrosourias. These are DNA alkylating agents, and carmustine and lomustines are the examples of nitrosourias. Oxazaphospins is another group. The examples are cyclophosphamide and ifosfamide. Basic mechanism of action is alkylation of the DNA and formation of inter or intra-strand crosslinks. Phosphorodiamidates and platinum-based antineoplastic agents are also there. So the platinum-based antineoplastic agents, they form crosslinking of DNA, but they form both inter and intra-strand crosslinks, or DNA and protein crosslinks are also introduced with these platinum-based antineoplastic agents in bacterial DNA, and because of which the replication of bacterial DNA is affected. Now, let us summarize what are the DNA replication inhibitors. DNA polymerase inhibitors, which were amikalin, then cytosine arabinoside, vernolepine, afidicoline. Amikalin, cytosine arabinoside, vernolepine, and afidicoline. These are the DNA polymerase inhibitors. Then under the category of DNA topoisomerase inhibitors, we have discussed anthracyclines and fluoroquinolones. Then we have seen the agents which are alkylating DNA or introducing inter or intra-strand crosslink or a crosslink between DNA and proteins. So we have discussed alkylosulfonates, mitomycin, nitrogen mustards, nitrosourias, oxazaphospinones, phosphorodiamidates, and platinum-based antineoplastic agents. So At the end of the session, you just have to enumerate this DNA replication inhibitor. This is the literature which is used for this video. I thank you very much for watching the video patiently. Keep watching, keep learning, and keep motivating us. Thank you so much.